The Kantech ioSmart readers may be deployed in a standard panel-based mode in which they are connected to a control panel such as the KT1, or they may be used in panelless mode. A reader used in panelless mode is not connected to a control panel and instead communicates with your smartphone. When used in panelless mode, users utilize their mobile devices as their key to grant entry to doors anywhere they are given access, without the worry of losing access cards and fobs. When installing the ioSmart reader in panelless mode, the reader is not powered from a central controller. Therefore, you will need to provide power to both the reader as well as your locking mechanism, which may take the form of an electric door strike, electric bolt, or mag lock. In some cases, you may be asked to add a diode to the locking mechanism. Follow the guide that comes with your device for installation. Depending on your chosen device, you may be able to power both the reader and the lock from a single power source. Use only copper wiring and be sure that the installation conforms to the local electrical safety codes and regulations. For continuous operation, in the event of a power disruption, you may consider powering from an uninterruptible backup battery power supply. This illustration depicts typical YGAN wiring color schemes. If using Cat5 cabling instead, it is recommended to combine two conductors for each power terminal, such as orange and orange-white for positive DC voltage and brown-brown-white for negative. Note that the reader can directly support a 12-volt locking mechanism and can be configured for fail-safe or fail-secure operation. If your lock requires higher voltage, you should use an isolation relay between the reader and the lock. Connect the 12-volt power supply ground to the ground terminal of the reader. Connect the power supply's positive to the power terminal of the reader. Connect an appropriate power supply positive to the lock terminal. This illustration shows both the reader and the lock powered by the same power supply. If your locking mechanism indicates that it has polarized terminals, connect positive to positive. Connect the lock's other connection to the I2O terminal on the reader. If you only intend to use a lock with the reader, the connections are complete and you may finish mounting the reader to the wall or box. If you opt to use a request-to-exit device, a door contact sensor, or both, you may also connect these in parallel to the I1 terminal on the reader. The use of a REX and contact sensor are optional, but must be wired for normally closed operation if used. Use 5.6K ohm and 11.1K ohm resistors in series with each as indicated.